The immunopeptidome is essentially a collection of all peptides on the cell surface. So they are kind of a mirror of what is going on inside the cell. And T cells have the ability actually to scan those peptides and really have an idea of what's going right or wrong inside the cell. They can actually see if there's an infection or if there's a tumor basically emerging. So they can recognize those foreign peptides on the cell surface. Then they can kill essentially the target cells, either infected or cancer cell, for instance. The overarching goal of the lab is to essentially develop and apply mass spectrometry-based immunopeptidomics to advance vaccine design and immunotherapies. Immunopeptidomics is an emerging science applying mass spectrometry to systematically measure all those peptides. So in essence, mass spectrometry is a technology to identify and to quantify proteins or peptides, so be able to really measure up to very high sensitivity what a T cell can actually see. We first start with cells or tissue, and we isolate those peptides. So this is digital microfluidics, where we use plates and you move cells based on electrostatic forces. And this allows you to essentially isolate those peptides from very few cells. In the middle of the workflow is the data acquisition using the mass spectrometer. And we partner with industry to really always be state-of-the-art technology with the most sensitive mass spectrometer. So we have the best approach to isolate peptides, best approach to acquire the data. And the last approach of the workflow is data analysis. So we build our own AI-based software to analyze those peptides with very high sensitivity and accuracy. So it's essentially kind of all the methods that we use to analyze the immunopeptidome. We have a short-term and long-term goal in the lab. The short-term goal is to basically be more on the therapeutic side of things, meaning helping design cancer vaccines, for instance. And in the long run is to associate immunopeptidomic signatures with disease severity or resistance. At the population scale level, can we actually look at immunopeptidomic signatures and identify signatures of people that are more at risk of specific diseases or more prone to respond nicely to some sort of new immunotherapies? Once we can scale up this technology or this field, I think the impact will be really tremendous.